Hi there! You voted on Instagram and you decided that I have to do a vlog in English, and because you all said that you wanted to have it in English, you now have to listen to me doing 12 vlogs this year of me speaking in English to an audience of people that probably speak very, very good English, while mine isn't that good because I'm from Germany. And if you ever wondered where I was from, yes, it's Germany. Whee! So, what will happen in this blog? I will actually talk about stuff that I liked during the last month, something like this. Because it's now the beginning of January, I will talk about the end of December and the beginning of January. And because it was Christmas and Sylvester, New Year's. I'm going to talk about this, and you're now going to see some videos of me having fun, something like this. So, as you have already seen, I spent some time at IKEA, and I actually bought some stuff. Not some of the stuffed animals that I love, but I found this little lamp, and I thought it looked like a fox. It's actually a raccoon, and so adorable. If you press the head, it starts to glow, and it's a night light, so it will shine the whole night through if you want to. And if you press it again, the little heart starts to light up in a red light. I'm not sure if you can see it on camera, but it actually has a little red light there, and if you press it again, it stops glowing. It's so adorable, cute, and I love it, and I have a thing for night lamps. I also found this candle that smells like breakfast cake. Breakfast cake it's called, and not sure if you have something like this in the US, but in Europe, breakfast cake is actually a thing. You can eat breakfast cake for breakfast, and there is actual cake for breakfast. Tastes a little bit like gingerbread, something like this, but not like gingerbread. It's more like gingerbread and honey mixed together, and it's fantastic. I love it. And this candle smells exactly like this. I also got one of the most fantastic things for Christmas. It's Mario Party 3 for the Nintendo 64, and it's actually a cartridge that you can use for the N64. I always loved this game as a kid, and it's one of my all-time favorite video games, but I never had an N64. As a kid, I always had to play with friends, and getting this one for Christmas almost made me tear up a little bit because so great. And I started reading Creative Inc., which is such a fantastic book. I know, you all knew that I would talk about books, right? Obviously, I have to talk at least about one book, and this is called Creativity Inc. by Ed Catmull, and it's written by one of the founders of Pixar. And he's talking about how he found Pixar, but also about creative working and how to work with a bunch of creative people. And I'm not sure how many people actually know this, but I'm working at an agency which creates websites. So reading something about creative people and how you can actually work together is pretty great for me. Plus, it is Pixar, and I love Pixar. I'm not even sure if I love Pixar more than actually Disney movies. Maybe, to some extent, I might actually love Pixar movies more, even though I would say that Disney made my childhood, but I love movies like Baymax or Inside Out. It's not called Baymax in America, I guess. I think the English title is Pequeño Number 6 or something, but it's Baymax in German, so don't care. It's Baymax and Inside Out and Toy Story. They're so great, all of them, and Up. Up is so fantastic. So, yeah, I love Pixar movies, and this book is great and talks a lot about how to work creatively. And yes, started the new year with a new project at work, and I'm really happy about it. I can't actually tell what I'm working on right now because it's confidential. So yes, but I work on a new project that's really, really exciting. I also got some money for Christmas and spent it all on AmiAmi, and I will do a follow-up video of me talking about stuff I bought at AmiAmi because this is not enough space for that. And I try to do something I would call poem night. So actually, in the moment, I realized that often when I sit in bed, I don't find the time to really read a lot, because mostly I maybe finish one chapter and then I fall asleep, and often I fall asleep right before that, or I start watching some bullshit on television or something like that. So I thought maybe if I read smaller portions of stuff in the evening, I would read actually more. Kind of makes no sense if you think about it, but I actually started reading poems somewhere in the end of November, and I actually liked it. So I bought a bunch of poem books, and I also got some for Christmas. So in the moment, I'm actually reading a huge mix of different poems. I got Shakespeare's sonnets because I'm so intellectual, actually realizing that most of the sonnets of Shakespeare are actually always the same poem, but a little bit different. For Christmas, I got these two books by Rupi Kaur. The first one is Milk and Honey, and the other one is The Sun and Her Flower. And all of her poems are so beautiful. I really, 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 really love them. I actually didn't read that much of Milk and Honey already, but I almost bookmarked every page I read so far. So I'm really happy with this one. And I also got two copies of books that are a little bit older, I guess. Well, that's a stupid word for this. Classics, you might call them. The first one is a copy of poems by Keats, and the other one is a collection of poems by William Butler Yeats, who I really, really love. I already read a few of his poems in German, but I actually think it's kind of pointless to read poems in a translated version, because if you translate a poem, you mostly use all of its meaning. It's so hard to translate a complete poem into another language, because it's actually not about telling a story. It's about telling something with some precise words, and it doesn't translate well. Point. It simply doesn't translate well. So yes, that's what I've been up to. I also did a lot of ballet during December. I joined a new studio in November, and I really, really love going there because the teachers are so great, and I can actually go every day to a beginner's class and so much better than my art studio. I loved my old teacher, but it's something different if you can go once a week or if you can go every day. And you and I watched the new Star Wars. I thought it was better than episode 7 and it was worse than episode 1. That's all I'm going to say because... Nope, that's all I'm going to say about this movie. I just wasn't happy. I hate Kylo Ren. That's just it. So, I hope that you might have enjoyed this thingy, this vlog, and that I see you next month. And I actually try to be a little bit more active on YouTube. So my goal for this year is to upload at least one vlog each month. But I also try to upload a little bit more stuff. So let's see how this ends. So I hope you enjoyed this and I see you next month. Or maybe before. Bye!